Today's obituaries are brought to you by Moss Service and Hansville Funeral Home. Deborah Ann Ketchum, age 51, died Thursday, June 27th in Horton, Alabama. A celebration will be held in Deborah's honor at 6:30 p.m. tomorrow at the Nicholson Pavilion at Heritage Park here in Cullman. Funeral services for Glennis Othell Hawes, age 71, of South Point, Ohio, formerly of Cullman, will be today at Moss Service Funeral Home Chapel. Larry Duke will officiate interment at Livingston Tabernacle Cemetery. Moss Service is in charge. Mr. Hawes passed away Thursday at Hospice House in Huntington, West Virginia. Funeral services for Wilburn Wayman Lambert, age 72, of Holly Pond, will be today at 12 p.m. at the Holly Pond Funeral Home Chapel. Dink Lambert will officiate interment at Holly Pond Cemetery. Mr. Lambert passed away on Saturday. Visitation will be today from 10 until 12 noon at the funeral home. Graveside services for Robert Harold Bobby Denton, age 74, of Falkville, will be tomorrow at 10 a.m. at Friendship Cemetery in Addison. Cullman Heritage is directing. Mr. Denton passed away yesterday at Falkville Healthcare. Visitation will be tonight from 6 to 8 p.m. at the funeral home. Funeral services for Reeford Martin Reeves, age 84, of Vine Manor, incomplete, and will be announced at a later time by Cullman Heritage Funeral Home. Mr. Reeves passed away Saturday at his residence. And those are our obituaries for today, brought to you by Moss Service and Hansville Funeral Home.
Welcome to Today on 2, brought to you by Premier Bank. It is a beautiful day, and you better enjoy it, because I think things are going to change.
I know.
We may have a wet 4th of July.
I don't want to hear it.
Okay. Should we just skip the weather forecast?
Just skip the weather.
Okay.
Don't tell me.
Here's our forecast for today. A 20% chance of rain after 10 o'clock today, with a high of 84 degrees. For tonight, 30% chance of rain, a low of 65. Tomorrow, we have a 60% chance of rain with a high of 82 for Thursday, Independence Day.
100%?
70% chance of rain.
Okay.
With a high of 79.
Wow.
Oh.
Wow.
And even more on Friday. We have a 70% chance of rain with a high of 77. Saturday, 50% chance of rain, high of 84. Sunday, high of 88 with just a slight chance of rain. Same on Monday, back into the 90s.
Of course,
but looks like Thursday and Friday could be a couple of rainy
yeah.
days.
Aww,
so enjoy today.
I guess so, huh? Mm-hmm. And if you were going to do anything for the 4th, well, make alternate plans.
Just tell the boss, I'll tell you what. I'm going to stay home today. I'll come to work Thursday.
Right, right. That sounds like a good idea, good plan.
Do something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, anyway, of course, we've had rainy 4th, but usually 4th of July is good weather.
It generally is. It yeah. really is, but oh, well. And you know, who knows? This may come through early and be done, and who knows?
Yeah. It's not like it's 100% chance.
No, right? That's right. That's true. But it's not looking good.
Okay. Who's our Facebook friend today?
Well, it looks like Cindy L. Harbison is our Facebook friend of the day, and she likes country music and Starbucks coffee. So good for her.
And I guess they go well together.
Yeah. Anyway, we're glad that she's our friend, and if you want to be a friend on Facebook, just like us on Channel 2 and spell out the number 2, Coleman. Yep.
And who's our guest for today?
Mr. Taylor Martin. He's with the Band Street Players, and they are performing Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat.
Have you seen that before?
I have not. You have, though, right?
It's a fun production.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I have not seen that, and I bet you it is. And, I think that you had said to me that our own little Miss Paige Harbison is in it. Mm-hmm. And then Taylor has been at, you're at Wallace, aren't you, Taylor?
Yeah, he's one of the Wallace singers.
That's what I thought. Mm-hmm. I recognized him. So very good. So this must be an interesting, fun play. And if you want to go see it, it's going to be held in Decatur, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Taylor, give us all the details.
Very good.
George is here with news and commentary right after this.
There's stuff around your house, but we don't make stuff. We make ovens. Dual-fuel, double ovens. And they bake so evenly that now delicious is something you can depend on. We only make things for one room. The best room. Your kitchen. We're devoted to it. And you can feel it in everything we make. Nobody knows the kitchen like KitchenAid.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Mouton. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
At Premier Bank, we take pride in serving our community. We respect our customers, and we've won awards for our ethical conduct. We're motivated to do all we can for you, and we're interested in your banking needs. We're efficient, safe, and sound, and our relationships with our customers are second to none.
At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
For news and commentary on this a Tuesday. It's going to be maybe a stormy day later on, but it's the way it happens this time of year, right? Looking at the news, Cullman County High School, or rather I should say, the Cullman County School System has been trying to replace a couple of principals. First of all, you had the Child Development Center, where the principal there has retired, as well as at Cold Springs. They were looking for a high school principal. Good Hope High School. Chris Chambers has been named the new principal of the Child Development Center, coming from another school system. They're working on Cold Springs. They're looking for one from there, but I think they've already decided on the Good Hope High School. You know, the thing about being a school principal, especially a high school principal, it has to be a good fit, does it not, in a community? People want someone that they feel is competent and can make sure their children get a good education. And sometimes it's hard to do, you know. I learned that there are some 39 positions to be filled across Alabama when it comes to superintendents trying to fill them. So the pool of available people is somewhat limited. And everyone's vying for that. And what are they going to be looking at, right? If you're a person who has a doctorate degree, you're looking at trying to get a good position, you're going to look for the pay. That's going to be part of it. Convenience, somewhere relatively near to where your family is. So, anyway, lots to be done in the county school system before we get cranked up, as well as the city school system, you know. They're looking for a new superintendent. So, lots to be done before school starts back. And speaking of the school systems, according to the Cullman Times, I guess that the county school system is looking at a grant, about a $200,000 grant, to add four more resource officers. Those are deputies that go from one system, one school to another, you know, throughout the day as safety, as protection. It's all it takes is one individual, and we've been blessed in Cullman County not to have that kind of thing, not as the kind of riffraff as we see in some counties around us. And so that is a testimony to the work ethic of a lot of good people in Alabama, as well as family values and a lot of other things. Nonetheless, they're trying to add four more resource officers through this grant, and they should know something about the grant if it is approved by next month. I don't know about you, but when it comes to driving in a parking lot, sometimes it's always catch as catch can. You know, when you're going, for example, in North Coleman parking lot, the shopping center up there, and you're trying to take a shortcut to get, let's say, from Food World up to Rite Aid, the pharmacy, some folks will take a roundabout way and not necessarily go around the regular drive around. But when it comes to parking lots, there's a lot to be said for watching what's behind you. Then the classy lady, Highway 31 North, had a lady yesterday backed over a gas main. This is the second time this has happened, right? And so Highway 31 was shut down for a while until I got that thing cleared up and the thing covered back up again. I can't say anything. When I was 16 years old, I went with my father to Tennessee. We spent the night and then got up the next morning and we're going to pick up a relative of mine, bring him back to Coleman. And as we started to back out of the parking lot of the little rec cafe, I had just got my license. I backed straight into a light pole. And I mean, my dad's coffee in the styrofoam cup goes all over the ceiling. And to this very day, I can remember looking up and seeing these little droplets falling off the ceiling. And at that point, Robert L. Spear looked at George and says, "I'll take over now." All right. Well, I guess that Secretary of State Beth Chapman has decided to resign. She has decided to go ahead and take a job in the private sector. She's already served, well, she's 17 months away from finishing her second term, but she cannot run for a third term. That's the way the Alabama laws is, you know, and such. And as a result, you have a situation to where we got to have somebody to fill a job, the position. They thought she might run for governor, but she says she likes Robert Bentley. She doesn't want to run against a friend, so that's what's happened there. In Huntsville, Congressman Mo Brooks says that the U.S. House of Representatives has already done all it can do by passing a series of bills that would cancel the furloughs, the sequestration thing. Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my. Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my. He said, we've already done what we can. And now we will have a president and administration who wants to do what? Cut defense? And what's happening in China? Doesn't that make you scared? It does me. Those characters, they take no prisoners over there. And fireworks, apparently, people in Birmingham are being reminded, don't break the law. You remember back about 10 years ago, or thereabouts, when Mayor Jack Sides was was the mayor in Coleman, and every time you turned around, you were being told, don't shoot firecrackers on the 4th of July, right? Don't put any political signs up. I haven't heard much out of the mayor or the city council in Coleman this time. Of course, I guess many people know that you aren't supposed to shoot firecrackers. But it doesn't keep you from doing. The Magic City is becoming more and more of a movie hotspot. People in Hollywood spending a lot of time in Birmingham. They also, unfortunately, spent too much time in Atlanta. Have you seen that Atlanta Housewives show? Talk about. You know what? If you've got money, it doesn't mean you have class. Because it is bad when it comes to some of these housewife shows. Real bad. And I don't see what people see in that. You know, I just don't. Other than using four-letter words. Beep, 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 beep. I beep, beep. They censor all that dialogue between them because they don't know how to express themselves without a four-letter word. And finally, Google. The good folks are into everything. There is no private moment with the Google folks. They have the Google Maps a lot of people used as a GPS feature and such, right? But now they're getting into what? They're getting into backpacking. If you can't get there with a car or a 4Runner or whatever, you're going to take one of these contraptions that has 36 cameras. So it's like a three-dimensional view. And whenever you take that trail, and they're looking for volunteers in places that are well-known, you know, natural-type places, then they'll have that available for people to use. You have a street view now that you can look at. They have a view. Someone drove past here, a 3D car, with a camera, you know. And as a result, you can go right past here. I keep looking to see what cars are parked in a lot out here, but it's too fast. Stay tuned. World Today on 2 after this.
At Premier Bank, we're a bit old-fashioned. We actually answer the telephone when you call. However, old-fashioned doesn't mean we aren't up to date. With the latest technology, Premier Bank meets the various needs of our customers. Mobile smartphone banking, internet banking, ATMs, convenient offices. At Premier Bank, we have the right products right now with good old-fashioned customer service. At Premier Bank, we put the customer first.
A long time ago, a million years B.C., the best things in life were absolutely free. But no one appreciated the sky that was always blue, and no one congratulated a moon that was always new. So it was planned that they would vanish now and then, and you must pay before you get them back again. That's what storms were made for, and you shouldn't be afraid, for every time it rains, it rains pennies from heaven.
Welcome back to Today on Two. It's time to give away our prizes. We have the lunch package from Mad Dog Mike's Barbecue in Berlin.
Yes, it's a
beautiful downtown
pack.
Berlin.
Yes, it's a family pack. Feeds the whole family. It's a good deal.
Yeah, a pound of meat and a couple of sides.
Right?
And, yeah,
rolls all
kinds
and
of good
all
stuff.
That good stuff. Yeah.
And we have the bag of assorted apples from Steel Orchard. Those are the prizes for today. Let's look at some of our ads. We'll ask you a question, of course, about one of these ads. And today we start with Renard's Gallery and Gifts, an art gallery, but much, much more than that. They have jewelry, they have clothing. Custom framing is available, Renard's Gallery and Gifts.
And there's Mad Dog Mike's Famous Barbecue, and of course it's country cooking. It has sandwich plates, ribs, salads, and more. Homemade sides every day. Special rates available for business, parties, weddings, anniversaries, and church events.
Yates Chance Christian Bookstore, a better way to shop for Christian entertainment. The MyEbo Color Tablet gives you song downloads, e-books, audio books, and Bibles, video games, and much more.
Mr. Hicks Menswear, located at 217 Compass Way Southwest, has businessmen's regular sizes, but he also has the big and tall sizes for those hard-to-fit guys. Mr. Hicks Menswear.
And Uniform Place, head to toe for summer. They have Landau uniforms, Med Couture, Allegria shoes, and that's Uniform Place on 2nd Avenue Southeast.
And Tires for Less is more than just tires. You can have your oil changed there. You can have minor engine repairs done. Shocks checked, brakes fixed. Go see Greg and the guys at Tires for Less right there on Highway 31 North.
And Earl's Body Shop reminds you, move over for emergency vehicles. They do towing, large and small towing, local and long distance. That's Earl's Body Shop on Highway 31 North.
And diabetic shoes are now available at Borden Family Pharmacy. They're located at Eva Road and Highway 157. This diabetic shoe is made by Dr. Comfort, and it's the finest quality diabetic footwear anywhere, everywhere, period.
Okay, our question for today. We have a tire store, tire dealer, called Tires for what? Complete the name of the store. Tires for what? 256-734-7399 is our telephone number. And we have the lunch special from Mad Dog Mike's Barbecue in Berlin and the bag of assorted apples from Steel Orchard. Quick look at the weather forecast. Slight chance of rain after 10 o'clock today with a high in the lower 80s. 30% chance of rain tonight, low in the mid-60s. And tomorrow, a 60% chance of rain with a high in the lower 80s. And we have a phone call ready to go. Hello, who's calling?
This is Sandra.
From where are you calling?
Here in Coleman.
Okay, the tire store is Tires for what?
Less, L-E-S-S.
Okay, Tires for Less, the right answer. Stay on the line, please. Actually, to clarify things, they also have tires for Jacqueline. They have tires for Dennis, and not just for Less.
Right.
But, yeah, they sell
for everybody.
They sell to everybody. That's
okay,
right.
Good.
Let's look at the rest of our merchant ads right now. Baldwin Counseling Center, Dr. Howard Rogers, can help you with weight loss, individual and family counseling, lifestyle coaching. Call for an appointment, 256-737-3087.
Brown and Company Beverages. This is a specialty wine and beer store. They have a beer cave. They have barware and specialty items. They're located on Highway 157 next to the Ford dealership.
All it takes is charisma and Doug Dogga Jewelers. For women who change their hairstyles, their clothes, and their minds, now you can change your jewelry to match with charisma.
And Mullins Body Shop. You've counted on them for over 50 years for auto body repair and towing, and you can count on them today. That's Mullins Body Shop, located in the Phelan area.
Deb's Bookstore is located just down the street from us, your hometown bookstore where browsers are always welcome. Gift certificates available at Deb's Bookstore.
Night Free Insurance, located at 410 First Avenue Southeast, and they do provide insurance for, they've been doing it now for over three generations, and it's one of the top 10 growth agencies in the state for auto insurance.
Auto Tech Repair and Service. They do major engine repairs, transmission repair, brake repair, foreign and domestic auto repair at Auto Tech.
And Coleman Wellness and Aquatic Center has a six-lane competition pool, full fitness center complete with weights, cardio, and professional training, indoor rubberized walking track, a variety of aerobic and cycling classes.
And Dairy Queen, we want to tell you about the blizzard of the month for the month of July. I think this is new. Lemon meringue is the blizzard of the month. I don't remember those flavors before.
I don't either, and I think that sounds awesome. Very good.
Okay, we showed you the merchant ads. Now it's time to check our birthdays for today.
We do have a couple. It looks like Jeanette Morris, I suppose, and Seth Harper are going to have birthdays today. And their name will be put into the drawing on Friday, where they have that possibility of winning a frozen ice cream cake from Dairy Queen.
And coming up next, we're going to find out all the details about Joseph and the amazing Technicolor Dream Coat.
In the nation, our agents are always there, helping make sure that when your life changes, your nationwide insurance coverage changes too. We put members first because we don't have shareholders. Join the nation where protection is personal.
Nationwide is on your side.
Got a woman mean as she can be. Well, got a woman mean as she can be. And sometimes I think she's almost mean as me. She got a ruby lips, she got shapely hips, yeah. Boy, she makes a royalty. But I got a woman mean as she can be.
Taylor Martin is here with us today, and he is a student from Wallace State, but he is this summer a busy man because he is performing in the Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dream Coat, which is a play that's probably, that's been around for a while, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I just have never seen it, but it sounds like it's an amazing play.
I think so.
You think so?
This will be my second time doing it in a full year, so we did it at Wallace in November. And then we're doing it now in July.
Now, are you playing the same character both times?
Kind of. The first time I was Zebulun, which is one of Joseph's brothers, and now I'm playing Simeon, which is another brother.
Right. He has quite a few, doesn't he?
11. a little bit bigger than my family, but not too much.
Yeah.
So, I really enjoy it. It's a really great show. I think everybody in at least a 150-mile radius should come see it.
Well, you know, and it's true, because is this held in the Princess Theater? Where do you actually have
actually,
it?
This production will be outside at Roseberry Park near the river. So you have, it's kind of like the Nile. It'll be outside on a stage. It'll be shaded by trees, and you can bring your own seats and picnics and blankets, and you can come and go as you please. And really good thing, it's free.
It is
a free event, and however, we will be taking donations for Bank Street. For they like to do free events for the community, but they need money to, you know, keep doing free events.
Everything costs money to do, right?
Unfortunately.
No, yeah.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. Okay.
But
so I got to be really nosy and ask, do you get paid to do this, or are you volunteering your time to do
volunteer.
This?
Volunteer.
Okay.
I would do this if I had to pay money to do it.
Okay.
That's how much I enjoy working, especially with this group of people, with with Lauren. She's the theater director at Wallace, and Paige, and we love to do it as much as, you know, we can, so if I had to pay every time I came down, I would definitely do it.
Okay.
I would. It's just a great time. It's a great experience. It's what I love to do, so why not?
I would imagine that you have on the big, heavy clothes that they used to wear back in those days, or are your clothes
you would
different?
Think, but this Joseph is a different take than the original show.
Okay.
It is going to be a 1960s, 1970s beach party.
Oh,
so every song will have a beachy feel.
Uh-huh.
If you know the show, Potiphar is a wealthy businessman. He owns the pyramids and stock and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to be like the millionaire from Gilligan's Island.
Oh,
very like,
okay.
You know, very.
Yeah.
And, you know, his little doo-wop girls are going to be Marianne and Ginger. And,
uh-huh.
And it's going to be very...
Thurston Howell.
Yeah,
third.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And then his wife will be Mrs. Howell. And,
yes.
You know, everything has that kind of... That feel. We
okay.
have a cafe scene that's a French number, and it's usually done in a French cafe,
mm-hmm.
and we're probably going to do a beachside bar with, like, you know, like, just sitting there, and you're in your beach chairs, and,
mm-hmm.
you know, feet propped up on a cooler, like you're just sitting at the beach, and I think that's a great idea. It was a great idea on her part.
Yeah, because I was wondering, wearing those heavy things in the summertime, and you're not even getting
yes.
paid to do this, you're
yes.
really dedicated.
Yes. But we get to wear, like, swim trunks
mm-hmm.
and like, short cutoffs and tie-dye shirts and vests and, you know,
right.
really cool stuff. And I'm very excited. I'm really glad we don't have to wear those heavy robes.
So now, is this a different twist on the regular play? Or is that the... Since I've never seen it, is that how...
Well, I was going to say, is the music the same?
The music is the exact same.
Okay.
The story is the exact same.
Uh-huh.
We're just putting the...
Okay.
environment around it different.
Okay,
we're going
okay.
to place it in a different area.
Okay. Okay.
Into a time that was like cooler and
mm-hmm.
and really
mm-hmm.
laid back.
Okay.
Which I didn't know about it at first. I was like, maybe.
So this is different from what you did in November.
Oh yes. Yeah.
Oh,
we
okay.
did the movie version, the Donny Osmond
right.
Stage version, which was very cool. I mean, it was great. Everybody
right.
loved it.
Right.
But I think this is something else that people are going to be like, oh, we can do that to shows. We can actually, you know, set Greece in the 20s instead of the 50s.
Right,
which
right.
is, hey, I'm up for that.
Yeah, it kind of sounds like that's what she's doing.
Yeah,
everything.
I love it.
So that's
love
very
it.
Good then.
When
so
are the performances?
July 11th through the 13th. And they're all at 7 o'clock. So it's, you know, when the sun's starting to go down
mm-hmm.
and it's going to be nice and cool
mm-hmm.
and you're right there on the river, so you have that nice little breeze. And so, yes, the July 11th through the 13th. And once again, it's free. So
okay.
please tell everybody.
Yeah. Just come on out. Be
yes,
supportive.
Yes, and you know, if you
yeah.
feel like you want to give a donation and you like what you saw,
mm-hmm.
tell everybody again. We'll be doing more shows and,
mm-hmm.
you know, hopefully more free events, sometimes at the Princess, sometimes outside or
right.
different venues, and we really love doing this. So
right.
we really hope everybody in Coleman comes to see it.
Well, it sounds like a great event.
We hope so.
And hopefully next weekend there is no chance of rain, so that way you will
right.
be
yeah,
okay
hopefully.
doing it outdoors. If it is raining, is it going to be postponed, or are we all going to do...
More than likely, yes.
Okay.
Or if it's, you know... If it's to where we can't do it within the weekend, we
uh-huh.
may have to just push it back.
Okay.
But
gotcha.
I think we put enough work into it that we're going to do it.
Okay.
So.
No matter what. All righty. Well, thanks so much for being here
Thank
today.
You.
And that's, of course, we need to remind everybody that's next weekend, Friday
yes,
and Saturday.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
We'll be back with more right after this.
At Premier Bank, we are very proud of the long-lasting relationships we have with our customers. Go almost anywhere to meet your banking needs.
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor our loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
Meet the KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop. It might just change the way you cook. Induction technology heats the pan and not the cooking surface to offer you a new level of precision, speed, and energy efficiency. 9 settings give you different levels of heat to achieve precise temperatures and amazing responsiveness. Water boils in just seconds, making this the fastest to boil induction cooktop available. The KitchenAid 36-inch induction cooktop.
Life lived in black and white is not a life lived. Today, I choose color. To see it. To feel it. To be in it. To be upon it. And to live a life surrounded by it. Today, I put on a fresh coat.
Now it's time for our community billboards brought to you by Pepsi and Coleman Jefferson Gas. The summer concert series are taking place at Recognition Gardens in Heritage Park every Tuesday, July the 3rd. Every Tuesday at 6:30, starting on July the 9th. And Be the Sitter That All Parents and Kids Want, Safe Sitter Babysitting Training Course is available. There are 2 more sessions left, July the 9th and 10th, and August the 13th and 14th. Give them a call, 737-2600, to register. And the Eva High School Alumni Association is presenting Flashbacks in Concert. That's on Friday, July the 12th, from 7 to 9. The Eva School Gymnasium is the place where it's going to be. And if you have any questions, 734-9489 is the number to call. If you have a community billboard you want to email us, you can send it to channel2coleman@gmail.com. You can fax it to 256-734-7680, or you can be a friend on Facebook, Channel 2 Coleman.
Weather forecast brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet. Make the switch to Mitch. The forecast for today calls for slight chance of rain later on today with a high of 84. For tonight, we have a 20% chance of rain, a low of 65. Tomorrow, a 60% chance of rain with a high in the low 80s. Who's coming to see us tomorrow?
Well, it looks like Nicolette Kilgo and Megan Walker are going to be here to represent the Teenage Republican Youth Leadership, well, the Teenage Republican area, Coleman area Teenage Republicans, and they're going to a youth leadership conference in Washington. So.
And usually they come back with some prizes.
Yes, they do. Yes.
One of the best clubs in the country.
It really is. So We're excited for them.
Okay. That's our program for today. Thank you for watching Today on 2.
Hope you have a great day.